Hello, welcome back again to another video. Now this video is a little bit kind of a fun thing to do using Kdenlive. You can create this kind of beautiful animation like this one here. So this is creating a sequence of images, and then you can import it into Kdenlive to create animation like this. So let's see how we can do that. So we're going to use an AI text-to-image generator to generate our sequences of images, and then we bring it into Kdenlive and we start creating the animation. So let's get started. So first of all, if you know about AI text-to-image generator, then you can choose one of them. But I encourage you to look at Maze.Guru. They have a nice image-to-image post generator. So once you're in here, make sure to create an account, and you can also use their Discord to generate image, or you can use the website to generate image. And also they have the application also available on Google and Apple Store. So we're gonna use this image that I have generated earlier. We're gonna use this as our post to generate new images from here. But we're going to generate the same post with different little bit of variations. So to do that, first we need to select the image, and then if you look at this one, we're going to send this image to the seed image here. So if you click here, you're sending this image to the seed image here, and then you can see the creativity level here. Make sure to bring this one all the way up to 50 or 60. Anywhere there is okay. And once you have that, now you can select the kind of model that you want to choose. So we're now trying to create exactly the same as this one. So we're gonna use the anim here, and then we can select the style we want to. So we're gonna select the style here, and then the artist, you can select any of these artists. So let's select one of them, and that's all you need to do. You can either choose any of this to use it to create that. So we're gonna use the one-on-one, the square, and it's gonna generate this. So let's generate, that's all you need to do, and we're gonna generate the images with the same post with different variations. So as you can see now, we have four different variations of the image to image post that we send it to the seed canvas here. And you can see this first one, there's the second one, a little bit variation from there, another one here again. And we can do the same again. We can use this and send it. So make sure to generate as many images that you want. Generate about 20 images. So I have already four here, and I'll generate another 16 more. So 4 times 5 rounds, and we get 20 images a sequence. So let's see how it comes out. So one thing to note of, you can use the creativity here to move the slider down or slider up to get different variations of your images. Okay, so we have generated some variations here, as you can see. And the next thing is to download them. So to download again, you simply select the image and you can click here to download. So I'm going to download this, and after this we're going to import this into Kdenlive. Okay, so all our images are being downloaded now. The next thing is to go to Kdenlive. So before we go to Kdenlive, make sure to know where you save your image, because we're going to go back into that folder, and also know the size of the image or the resolution of the image here, one-on-one. So if we go to Kdenlive, here's Kdenlive, our project profile here is not 1-on-1, it is 16:9. So let's go to the project here, and once you're in the project, go to project setting, and in the project settings, go down to custom, and in the custom, go all the way down, and you find square. So if we go here, you can see the square here, that's the one we want, and we want to use a higher frame, here 60 frame per second. Once we have that, let's click OK. And when you click OK, it's gonna give you this. It's asking you to change the current profile, which is this landscape here, to the square, the one that we just changed to. So let's click on continue. And once we click on continue, you can see already here we have the square, which is the size of our images. The next thing to do is to import in the image sequence. To do that, come to the project bin, And in the project bin, do a right click and you can see add image sequence. So click here. Now this is very important. So again, here in the folder, that is where we save our variations of the sequences of images. So let's click here to point the link into that folder. So once you click here, go to where you save that image for us. It's this one here. So once you put the folder, the link into that folder, click select, and you can see that when you do that, you can see the images appeared here. If they don't appear here, that means you come to the image type and change to the image type that you generated and downloaded, whether it is PNG or any other of this. For this case, it's JPG. So let's leave it as it is. Another important thing to note of is the frame duration. So here we have 5 here. Let's just change this to 0, and here change this to 1. And that's all you need to do. And if you want to change the animation type here, pan, fan, zoom, and zoom, you can do that. But I think we can just leave it as it is, as none. And that's all we need to do, and click OK. So here we just imported all our images into the project bin. The next thing is drag this to the timeline, and here are the images, as you can see on the project monitor here. So you can see in the beginning here, some of the images are kind of like variation is a little different. So those kind of images, if you can go back again and delete that and import in a new sequence again. For this purpose, we just go ahead with that. So we can trim from here. So just trim up this one here and bring this one in. Okay, so that's all. We imported the sequence into that. And if you want to do a little bit of color correction to the images, you can do that. For this case, let's go to the effects here, and under the color and image correction, you click on that, and I just want to use lift, gamma, and gain. Select lift, gamma, and gain. And if you don't know how to use the lift, gamma, and gain, we have a video about that right out there, so you can watch this video if you want to know how to use lift, gamma, and gain. That's all we can do for this. You can do some other things like applying the base yet here, or you can apply the LUT if you have the LUT there. You can do that, but for now that's all, and that's it. And click render, just type in a file name, and you can use the ultra high definition or low list here, up to you. Just use this one, and let's render our animation. Okay, so rendering is done, and here is the final result. Okay, so that's all for this video, and thank you for watching. Thank you again, see you back again in another video.